Speak from the word of God, and for a short message I would like to read from Romans 8:28. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. And we all know what's special about next Sunday, which is the February 14th, besides Selvin's and Lichardson's birthday. And we can see all the stores, all the streets are filled with flowers, teddy bears, and all this good stuff. And that's the day when all the people are showing their love and affection for one another by giving like gifts, flowers, messages, or cards. But what we can see outside, all the human relationships are conditional, based upon their future expectations. If these conditions are, or if these conditions or expectations are not met, then the love is broken. And we can see in Luke 6:32, if you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners love those who love them. Because like in the world, it will say, okay, I will love you if you love me back, or if you give me gifts, or if you are a good provider, then I will love you. But Jesus, he loved us like unconditionally, without any conditions, even with our faults, and he still loved us. And today I would like to focus on three reasons why we should love God. And the first one, the sacrificial love of God, the most important one, the love he showed himself on the cross. And we believe in a God of love, and it says in Hebrews 12:2, Jesus Christ, God in human flesh, endured the pain of the cross of Calvary because he loves us. He gave up his place in heaven, so in order to come down to earth, to be beaten, to suffer, for suffering and shame, and crucified for our sins. And Jesus died for us while we were still sinners, and while we were still enemies. That's the agape love. He loved us first, and his love is manifested through his begotten son. We all know the key verse of the Bible, John 3:16, because he sent his only begotten son the world, that it we might live through him. And because he is worthy of all our praises, and deserves all the glory and love, because he left the heaven's glory to come down to earth, to be rejected and crucified for our sins. So that Jesus did it all because he loved us unconditionally. And the second one, he's a prayer answering God. And we've been hearing about this topic like last week, and from fasting prayer, about like different types of prayers. And we all experience that love, because even when we are not worthy, he loved us, and he answered our prayers in the midst of all the impossibilities. And prayer is an essential part of our relationship with God. In John 14:14 says, whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, so the Father may be glorified in the Son. Joyce talked about this last week. Not because only for our benefits, but he will be also glorified. Then sometimes we get the answers differently, like immediately, or sometimes way longer, or sometimes even it will be entirely different than what we expected. And the best example I can say about prayer is the story of Daniel. He came to Babylon as a captive, and he faced several crises. But in midst of all the crises, he didn't change his priorities, or he didn't change his practices. We can see in Daniel 6:10, he continued kneeling on his knees 3 times daily and giving thanks before his God, and as he had been doing previously. So he knew all the provisions, all the circumstances, everything came from the God for his good and for God's glory. And he became the prime minister in Babylon in front of all the greatest kings of the Babylon. And I know we heard different types of prayer last night, but it's not necessary to have the same type of prayer or at the same place. It could be while we are driving, or in work, or in school, in colleges, even listening to songs that can give us comfort or hope, when we're in a hopeless situation. And the best example is our Appachan. There was not a single day without him singing and praying for multiple times a day. And I surely believe he brought us this world because of their prayers and God's grace. And from this Daniel story, we can learn that if you kneel before God, you will be able to stand before anyone. And how can we not love a God who hands us our prayers like without looking at our faults and iniquities? And the next one is he's a compassionate and forgiving God. And his desire is everyone to get the eternal life without restriction in this world. He's a compassionate God, and in Psalms 145:8 says, "The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, and rich in love. Even when we fail many times in our daily walk, He still loved us and He had compassion on us." In Matthew 9:36, we read, "When He saw the crowds, He was deeply moved with compassion for them, because they were troubled and helpless, like a sheep without a shepherd." So He understands the nature of a sheep. He knows that if we get lost, He is unable to come back without the help of a shepherd. And that's us. In Psalms 103:13, verses 13 and 14, "As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear Him. For He knows how we are formed. He remembers that we are dust." We know the properties of a dust. When you look at the dust, even with a small wind, it can stay still. And with the rain or with an even storm, it will vanish away. But God's, it means that God created us. He knows that we are dust, and we have aware of all our needs and burdens, pains, all our thoughts. But I want to say, like, in compassion, like, we have nothing to be proud of. Even the breath we are taking now, like, we are accountable for to praise Him and thank Him. And in conclusion, this is just as like three simple reasons out of like thousands or millions of reasons why we should love Him. And I want to ask everyone, can Jesus be our Valentine? Like, can we love Him more than anything in this world? Can we say that we will love Him more than anything in this world? And let that be our desire, to love Him more in each day of our life, and live a life pleasing unto Him. And may and surely all things will work together for those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. May God bless us with His words, and thanks again for the time. Amen.